This is what U.S.-backed regime change used to look like back in the days. In a bid to ensure U.S. political and economic interests were safeguarded, CIA-backed coup d'etats ousted democratically elected leaders from Mohammad Mossadegh in Iran to Salvador Allende in Chile. In their place, all too often, brutal dictatorships and governments that committed heinous crimes against their people. By the 1980s, the reign of terror that blazed across Latin America by Washington's henchmen was too much for most people to stomach. To replace the overt support for dictatorships, a new concept for regime change was born, one that sounds and looks better: democracy promotion. The concept of democracy promotion is simple. Finance, train, and politically back local opposition forces around the world that support Washington's agenda. Dr. William Robinson is the foremost expert on regime change through democracy promotion. He wrote the book Promoting Polyarchy.
In Latin America, in Eastern Europe with the Velvet Revolutions, in Africa, in the Middle East, all over the world. And so the U.S. set up these different mechanisms now for penetrating the civil societies and the political systems of countries that are going to be intervened, and to assure that the outcomes would be pleasing to Washington's foreign policy objectives.
We do this through surrogates, and we do this through non-governmental organizations, and we do it through people who are less suspecting of the evil that may lurk behind their actions than perhaps they were before. Have we learned some lessons in that regard? You bet. Do we do it better? You bet. Is it still just as heinous as it always was? You bet.
So while the goals remain the same, it's no longer the CIA but the U.S. Agency for International Development, USAID, and its partners spearheading this effort. Alan Weinstein, one of the founders of the National Endowment for Democracy, explained to the Washington Post in 1991, a lot of what we do now was done covertly by the CIA 25 years ago. And like the CIA, USAID, the National Endowment for Democracy, and a slew of similar organizations receive funding from Congress.
Millions and millions of U.S. taxpayer dollars go every year into funding for political organizations and campaigns in different countries around the world that promote U.S. agenda. And most U.S. citizens are unaware of the fact that that's how their money is being spent, to meddle and influence and interfere in other nations' affairs.
The concept of facilitating regime change through democracy promotion has garnered widespread criticism, not just abroad, but also here at home. Congressman Ron Paul once wrote, "It is particularly Orwellian to call U.S. manipulation of foreign elections promoting democracy. How would we Americans feel if, for example, the Chinese arrived with millions of dollars to support certain candidates deemed friendly to China?"
I think it's terrible. We use taxpayers' money to go over and use our military and our CIA and these programs to say this is what you ought to do and influence them. There's no authority for that. It doesn't work. It teaches a lot of people to despise us.
In tomorrow's segment, we'll introduce you to the political figures who became national and international stars with the help of U.S. democracy promotion funding, and explain exactly how the system works. Jahan Hafiz, RT, Washington, D.C.